Hi everyone. Today, we will see how to configure VTScada software to read and write to Outseal Arduino PLC as a Modbus client device. Modbus is a communication protocol for data transmission between two or more devices. There are several variants of the Modbus protocol, but the Modbus serial or ROTU is currently supported in Outseal PLC. The Modbus ROTU runs over RS-485 protocol with one master and several slave devices for a distance of up to 1 km. It can also run over RS-232 or TTL interface with just a master and a slave device for distances not more than 15 meters for RS-232 and 2 meters for TTL interface. Each slave device should have a unique Modbus address from 1 to 255 with 0 assigned to the master device. The terms master and slave were replaced with server and client by the Modbus organization in 2020. Data is organized in Modbus client devices and stored in data locations as discrete output coils, discrete input contacts, analog input registers, and holding registers. Outseal PLCs are by default Modbus clients. The Arduino Nano as an Outseal PLC uses the TX and RX pins for Modbus communication. Outseal PLC Modbus client data organization is as shown for the relays, memory bits, switches, analog inputs, and holding registers. For today, we will only consider the discrete output coils and input contacts using the point-to-point single server single client Arduino Nano USB connection to the computer. Now, set up the PLC circuit connection as shown with a PC817 model having a push-button switch connected to S.1 pin of the Arduino PLC and a relay model having 4 indicator lamps connected to pins R.1 to R.4 of the Arduino PLC. Pull up this control logic from video number 10. Drag a branch into row 0 and insert contacts into the branches with variables S.1 and B.1. Go to settings and set the hardware type as Nano V5. The COM port of your Nano, a baud rate of 115200, and a Modbus address of 1. Note these parameters as they will be required in VTScada. Then exit and upload the code to the Nano. Download VTScada Lite from the link in the description. Fill in the required information and click on Send to display the custom download link. Follow through with the installation process. Click on the checkbox to use VTScada for free. Note that the free version is limited to just 50 tags license, which is more than enough for this video. Select the VTScada architecture that matches your computer. Then click on Finish to commence the installation, which should take a while. Ensure that Launch VTScada is checked and click on Done to open the application. Add a new application from here. Name the application Modbus Digital Read-Write. Then click Next and Finish to launch the application. First, we will create a connection tag for the port to the PLC. Click on the tag browser icon at the top left of the application. Click on the new button, Ports, and then Serial Ports. I will name mine COM4. Select the Settings tab and type in the port number your Nano is connected to. Set the baud rate to 115200. Then click OK. Next, create a tag for the driver by first right-clicking on the port tag and select New Child. Click on Drivers. Then scroll down to select Modbus compatible device. Type Modbus driver as the name. Select the Options tab and ensure Modbus ROTU is checked. Under the Serial tab, click on the tag icon beside Port to select the COM port that was initially created. Then click on the Select button. Ensure that the PLC address is the same as the Modbus address from Outseal Studio, which is 1 in this case. Then click OK. Now we can create tags for the 4 coils, the memory bit, and the switch. Select the Modbus driver and click on New. Click on Digitas and then I/O and Calculations Digitas. Set arrow.1 as the name. On the I/O tab, set the read address to 1, which is the Modbus address for arrow.1. Then click OK to display the created tag. Follow through the previous steps to create tags for arrow.2, arrow.3, and arrow.4 outputs with the corresponding Modbus addresses of 2, 3, and 4. The same steps are applicable in creating tags for the switch and the memory bit, but the Modbus read address for the switch is 10001. And for the memory bit, the read address and the write address will be 129. To create the user's interface screen, select arrow.1 and click on the Draw button. This will open the Idea Studio and display the I/O and Calculations widgets. Double-click on the Indicators folder. Select Round 1 Indicator, and then click on the Idea Studio to place the Indicator widget. Repeat the steps for arrow.2, arrow.3, arrow.4, and S.1. For B.1, click on the Home icon. Double-click on the Buttons and Switches folder, and then the Basic Controls folder. Select the Set Value button, and click on the Idea Studio. Repeat this again for B.1. Then close the tag browser. Now select and delete the default graphics from the Idea Studio, and rearrange the widgets accordingly. Double-click on the left Set Value button. Type Run in the State 0 label text box and Running in the State 1 label text box. Click on the Write 1 Immediately Radio button and click OK. Double-click on the other Set Value button. Type Stopped in the State 0 label text box and Stop in the State 1 label text box. Click on the Write 0 Immediately Radio button and click OK. Now close the Idea Studio and click Overview. Observe that when the Run button is clicked on, the text is changed to Running and the indicators on the screen and the PLC are turned on one after the other and then go off. When the Stop button is clicked on, its text is changed to Stopped and the indicator lamp sequence is turned off. Also, observe that the indicator for S.1 is on when the push button switch is held down to start the indicator sequence. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we will consider the Modbus analog and holding registers over RS485. Please click on the like button. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon.